Hello, everyone. Welcome back to FNAF World. We gotta continue that update 2 shit. We have a lot to do today. However, there are some other things I want to get out of the way. By the way, I'm almost done with hard mode. I'm very close. I just need to beat the security system, and then we'll see what's next. I don't have as many animatronics, though, as I would like. But I think I can do with my current team. Regardless, we're gonna be doing something a little different today. So, since I'm almost done with this game, at least the update 2 part of it. Oh, fuck, I forgot about this. Give me a moment. I guess I left off here last time. I don't remember how, but I did. Ow. This guy's a lot easier now. Especially now that I have the illegal animatronics that I shouldn't have. And it's so overpowered, I love it. Try your worst. So anyway, I was watching MatPat's playthrough of this game, and he discovered a few things that I didn't. No surprise there. One of which is every single time that you talk to Fredbear, if you let it stand there when you finish your conversation with Fredbear, you don't click done, it'll swap to like an 8-bit, you know, really tiny version of Fredbear, kind of like from the Five Nights at Freddy's 4 minigames, and he'll tell you to do something else. It leads to another ending. It has to do with these weird little mini-games and some clocks. I'm not entirely sure what they mean. The thing is, I think I mentioned this before. In Five Nights at Freddy's... No, at the start of this game, there was a black screen with yellow eyes, like yellow dots, like eyes, and there was some guy talking to you. I don't actually know who it was. I forget. But basically, he told you that, like I said at the beginning of the Let's Play, he said a lot of things that were very reminiscent of what Fredbear says to the kid after the events of Five Nights at Freddy's 4. Like, putting you together, putting something back together, you know, that kind of thing. So, when you finish all the clock stuff, because I'm not going to do it, I would have to start another game to do that all. He talks to you again, and he tells you once again a lot of things very similar to the ending of Five Nights at Freddy's 4. And how all the pieces are in place or something like that for something else that's coming. And then, you know, the end. Very interesting stuff, even if I don't entirely know what it means. However, today we're going to be getting an ending. And we're also going to be getting a few bonus things that I actually got in my hard mode run. What are they? Well, you'll see. So, MatPat, I also saw him do this. Or at least one variation of this. Because people in the chat were telling him. As you know, there are a bunch of red treasure chests scattered all throughout this game. What was that? And in order to get them, like, it's really hard to get them. It's like you can't actually reach them. They're always in closed off locations. There's no glitches, nothing, no walls you can walk through. When I was playing the game myself on hard mode, I only had two more Fredbear conversations to listen to. And one of which told me, yeah, go get the last clock, but at that point it was already too late, I missed all the other ones, but I still got it anyway. And another one told me that there are red chests that will basically break the game in your favor, and in order to get them, you need to glitch out of the game. Like, glitch out of bounds. And so I'm like, oh, I can do that. And so he told me where you can go to glitch out of bounds, and get the chest, and I did. I got all the chests. I, of course, had some help to find a few of them, because I actually forgot where they were. Once that was done... Everything was all nice and dandy. So I have all the red, what are they called? All the red, chests in my hard mode game, which is awesome. So that'll definitely make finishing the hard mode a lot easier. And now we're gonna get them here. What you saw me doing, going around the outside of Black Tomb Yard, yeah, that'll lead you to a boss fight with this guy again, who, if you remember, was also protecting the Pizza Fury chip. Wow. Man, I love these guys. So yeah, he was also protecting the Pizza Fury chip. So, this one is protecting Frettle Fury, which, as the name implies, will make it so Frettles are almost always up in your enemy's face, and that's pretty damn cool. Alright, let's go get another one now. So check this out. And now I have glitches. Out of bounds of the game. And now I can just walk over everything because, you know, I glitched it. These guys are really weird though, I'll say that much if it wasn't obvious enough. The funny thing is, I went onto the FNAF World wiki to read about this or that. Nothing too spoilery. I forget what I was looking for. But I found the music of the game and there was like an inverted battle theme. And I had no idea what the fuck it was for until I saw MatPat glitch in the game because his audience told him to. And I was like, oh, okay, that's why it exists. Oh, these guys actually know Alarm. The same move that, see, the same move that the security system uses. So for those guys, you definitely want to have someone with Neon Wall if you're going to be glitching through walls. And here, that's how you get to this guy. I don't think I need to tell you what that does. Or maybe I do. So yeah, it's very broken, these red chips. The only issue is that when you glitch into the game, you can't jump to any of the locations since you're glitched. You have to go back to the glitch to get out. Which is an issue because some glitches are pretty far away. At least one is. Only one is, honestly, in my opinion. So I guess it's not really that much of an issue, actually. Oh well. That's why you don't listen to me. Anyway, so that was one glitch. We have to glitch, I think, two more times to get some of the other chests in the game. How do I... Alright, there we go. And now I'm out. So let's go get another one. Yeah, and don't worry, I'll be back to the update 2 stuff, because I am... Another thing that we're going to do today, not in this episode, but during my current recording session, in my time, we are going to complete FNAF in space and get whoever's there, and I'm going to, off screen, because there's going to be a lot of repetition, try to get an A rank in Foxy Fighters to get a fourth and final Halloween update character, or update 2 character. And then after that, we're going to try to tackle the rest of the game. Of course, since the characters start off weak, I'll probably off screen fight the security system a bunch of times so that I can level them up, which is what I did for the Night Marionette and the Jacko Chica. Alright, here we go. Yay, this is fun. Yeah, the reason Fredbear told me about this is because for the entire game, at least if you're listening to Fredbear, the glitchy Fredbear is trying to convince you that something else is going on. And that if you're playing the game just to play the game, you know, like if you're just playing it the normal way, that you're doing it the way that he wants you to do it, whoever he is. You know, someone's pulling your strings and you're letting him by doing everything the way that he wants you to do it. And it's like, oh, well, that's not good. And the last time that you talk to him is right before you fight the security system. So he's like, well, I guess you're just gonna ignore me and go do the game normally. So at least let me tell you this. What's coming up next is hard, so go do these glitch things. Granted, all he tells you is that there's a bird on a stump and a gravestone that you can glitch into. You don't actually know which ones those are. You have to find them on your own. And he also, of course, just tells you that the red, wow. That's so cool. That the red chests are broken. Basically. In his nice Fredbear way of saying it. Well, actually, the glitch Fredbear isn't all that nice. He's very desperate to get you to do the thing. And there we go. I think that's all of them. Yeah. In hard mode, I also do not know where Head Start speed is. So, whoops. That's kind of funny. It's one of this it's in the weak class of chips, the first class. It should be one of the easiest ones to find. I have no fucking clue where it is. Oh wait, there's already an enemy bomb. I was gonna say, whoa, did I glitch it? No, it's just the Mimic Ball. I think we've had enough glitching for today. This went by a lot quicker. Then I guess in hard mode, the enemies have more HP and stuff, so they take a lot longer to get through and murder. But yeah, there we go. That was the glitch exhibition. Hope you all enjoyed it. Now we're gonna go get an ending. Alright? Because there's an ending that we can get that I've actually wanted to see what it is, so I haven't finished watching MatPat because he's gonna get all the endings in his next part, and I haven't watched it yet because I want to wait until I get this one at the very least because I want to see what it is. Also, I want to give you any sort of reaction if there's a reaction to give. If. Oh shit. I have to turn on find characters. I might not be using the other guys, but I still want them. Whoever's left. How many characters am I missing anyway? Let's take a look-see. I'm missing like the really interesting ones that I want. Nightmare Foxy. I don't have Nightmare Foxy? I have him in the other game. In my hard mode game, that's crazy. Plush Trap, Funtime Foxy, Nightmare, Fredbear, and Spring Bonnie. So I'm only missing six animatronics. I really want Nightmare, Fredbear, and Spring Bonnie. And I guess Funtime Foxy's pretty cool too. But that's what I really want. And of course, everyone on the bottom is from the Halloween stuff, update 2. Which, at the minimum, I'll be getting 4 of them, 5 at max. Because I just want to see how I can do if I'm better at Freddy in space. And if I am, I'll try it again. Because you can actually get 2 animatronics from it. I think I mentioned this before, but I'll say it again. You get 1 animatronic for beating FNAF in space. Whoa. I didn't know money spawned there. You get 1 animatronic for beating FNAF in space with all the laser upgrades, and you get another one for beating it with none. So, yeah, I'm gonna try it with all the upgrades first. That's what I'll be doing. I'll at least record that run. Everything else, though, I'll just do on my own time and see if I can get these people so I can try to finish the game. I'm in no rush, honestly. I'm just saying that I want to finish it because I want to finish it. I keep forgetting I don't need to do that. I was gonna check something, but I guess it doesn't matter. See, these chips are crazy. There's one that gives you a Mimic Ball automatically, one that gives you a Neon Shield automatically, one that makes you invulnerable to getting screwed. And, you know. Okay, so here we go. Let's go get that ending. Here we go. Actually, there's another one that I do want to get, but I wonder how hard that'll be. Not hard as in hard, but it's totally up to chance. They said not to go more than 3 glitches down, right? Well, here's another glitch. Let's go do it. Why am I at a lake and who's fishing? I'm sorry to say that you have gone too deep into the code. There is no way back out. My name is Old Man Consequences. Come here, have a seat. Let's fish for a while. You've nowhere else to go. Hmm. Old man consequences, huh? Is he gonna be in sister location? Well, there you have it. That's an ending. Alright, so I'll be right back. Let me just hop back into the game really quickly. And there we go. I got another little figure. Yeah, they add on more of these guys for, well, you know, obviously for the various things that you do. Okay, let's change my second team very quickly. Give me a moment. Who can I use? Old man consequences. I do have to admit, I did kind of get freaked out when I went into the, when I went down there and there was no noise, like everything went silent. I was honestly a little freaked out. All right, so I think it's down here, yeah? Nope, it is not. All right then. I actually don't remember where this is, or how to get in here anyway. Think. No, I think I know now. This has been a fun game, honestly. I mean, I know I'm still not anywhere close to done, because the final area is like a maze, as if that was necessary. So it will take a bit longer to finish the game, but that's fine. It's been a fun ride, I really enjoy it. The craziest thing about watching MatPat playing it is realizing how different the original release is compared to this update. Like the updated version with the new menu, the new options and shit. It's a very different game. Or at least it's a much more polished game. And it's a lot of fun. I really don't like the circuitous route, but I was right, because I remember back before that I noticed that there was like something here, like in the left wall when you're off screen. Like it felt like a key spot or something. I just never came back to do it. I kept thinking I should go back and see what's there. And then of course MatPat did it first. I'm like, well, now I know what's there, but I'm gonna go do it anyway. I have no guarantee that I'll pull this off, so if I don't, you'll get to see more hard cuts while I have to do this again. Here we go. We're through a door. Chipper's revenge. Come on. One of these has to work. A 30% chance is not that bad. Come on, people. Get it together. Well, that's gonna end up well. Shit. That guy's really tough. But yeah, from what I'm aware, at least if the people in MatPat's chat are to be believed, that guy is unkillable except for unscrewing him. And I was hoping I had someone with unscrew too, but it honestly doesn't look like it, which is fascinating. Mm-hmm. Nailed it. Third try. This isn't fair. It was never fair. It was supposed to be me. It was always supposed to be me. My world was lush and beautiful, full of strange and colorful creatures, but no, that wasn't enough for you. You wanted to be scared, you wanted to feel dread. And what happened to me? What happened to us? Obscurity. You haven't seen the last of me. Freddy Fazbear isn't the one who will be sharpening his teeth on your bones. It will be me. It will be me. For some reason, I doubt that, Chipper. I actually did it. Okay, I was not too sure if I could. So anyway, I think that's all we need to do. So I will at least go give Radiant Space another try. See if I can beat that one finally. So let's go do that now. Alright, check it. I got 3 now. Awesome. Anyway, onward to update 2. Again, unfortunately. Here we go. Five Nights at Freddy's 57. Freddy in space. What are you doing here? Yeah, blah, 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 whatever. Okay, so, real talk. I looked up exactly what it is that I'm supposed to do. Like I said before, you can get multiple animatronics from this mission. And, from this minigame. The one I'm going for, or multiple characters at least, they're not all animatronics. The one I'm going for requires getting all the cupcake upgrades. And I decided to look up where they all are. Because you know me, that's what I do when I get frustrated. And it actually turns out there's 9 of them, which I think the last time I played the game, I thought I had them all. Is it for some reason I felt like I did? I think I only picked up 5 though. Because after a certain number of pickups, it becomes very obvious that I didn't get the max. But regardless, now that's what I'm gonna try to do. I get another animatronic for another character for beating it with no picking up none of the upgrades. I imagine that's probably the hardest way to go, if anything. So yeah, let's not do that. And I still have to give Foxy Fighters a few more tries to see if I can get the A rank. Which I also found out that the A rank in Foxy Fighters, you need 175 points. And that's between enemies killed and the health left. So like 150 enemies, 25 health. 120 enemies, 55 health. You know, just as long as you can get that high. And yeah. Oh man. That's what I get for talking while trying to do some very, very difficult platforming. It's not difficult at all. I'm just pathetic at it. It's always the easiest looking things that I just screw up on for no good reason, honestly. These security cameras suck. I think you can destroy them. You probably can. I never have. I think I did maybe once or twice, but I avoid destroying them because it's not worth it, in my opinion. Which is funny because I get annoyed by them so many times. It's like, why don't you just kill them? Basically, there's no good reason for why I don't just kill them. I'm just stupid. That's all you need to know. Anyway. I do wish health drops were more obvious in this game. I mean, more common, not obvious. It's a giant heart. What do you think it is? I think it's funny that I always wind up killing those two guys and jumping up there, even though it's pointless, because I can't jump over this other guy. Like, the ceiling will just bonk me down. But whatever. Who actually cares about that? Stupid random tentacles. And stupid bouncing goop things. I don't know what they are, but they're clearly the worst enemy in this game. Like, nothing else compares how annoying those stupid goopy goops are. So, you know, screw those guys. Things, actually, more accurately, but whatever. Did I bring up my hard mode game? I actually don't know. It's going along fine. I haven't actually tried yet to, beat the security system, though I do have a good amount of stuff. I don't know, actually. I'm missing some of the later animatronics, and I assume that the later animatronics, the last few, are the strongest, so it'd probably be best just to wait till I get them. Ready Cinematic Universe. I'd watch it! And Nook is always so curious. Because I'm always wondering about, like, come on, there has to be something in there. Old games always said that, oh, those odd nooks, yeah, we hid stuff in there. It's like, well, clearly not in this case, whatever. Anyway, hard mode. Whatever, there's really nothing else to say there. I haven't finished it yet, maybe I will, maybe I won't, I don't know. It's difficult. By the time this one goes up, I think I would have posted my special video, so I guess I could talk about it. Yeah, why not? This is, what is this? I think this is episode 13? Yeah. Episode 10 was the first one where I, played update 2, and I got, jump scared during the Foxy EXE minigame, so I just isolated that part and looped it over a bunch of times for a short video, so you can just listen to me scream like a little girl. A lot of fun! That was fun to do, but I legitimately screamed when that happened, which kind of surprised me, myself, as it came out of me, but what do you expect? It really sucks knowing that you made it this far, and yet... I should've known! There's a ledge near the beginning of the game I remember that I tried to jump to, I think either the first or second time I played this game. And it turns out that's where I have to go now that I have the jump ability. And I don't know how I didn't know that. Because, you know, last time when I got the jump ability, I just spent forever backtracking around this area, and then I eventually got killed. Rightfully so, because I had no idea where I was going. Anyway... Okay, I'm back. I actually just clicked away a bit to double check the locations of all the cupcakes to make sure that I won't miss any, because some of them are in areas that I haven't been to yet, like, at all. But, I think I'm good. I think I have it all in my head. I hope I do anyway. This one, though, I already knew about this one. I got this one before, so I'm fine. I don't know which one this is, but yeah, see? I totally forgot to bring it up. Oh man, my laser now has double. So, I think the last time I played the game, I did not get double laser, so... Yeah. I really thought I had all the upgrades. I was so like, yay! This is a really fun game, honestly. This and Foxy Fighters are pretty fun. Foxy EXE is stupid and doesn't deserve to exist. And the Rainbow Chica mini stupid thing? Yeah, fuck that thing. That thing is even... That's the worst thing ever created. Which reminds me, since I'm all done with the game, I might as well go look someone up completing that. I'm actually really interested to see how you can wrap it up, and see if any of the dialogue changes with the rainbow as you get further in the level. Because I'm not gonna do it. I don't have the patience for that kind of stuff. I absolutely do not. So... What do you get for completing that, anyway? I think you unlock Chipper from Chipper and Sons, Scott's, like, what, first game? No. That was, Well, whatever it was the game to, get Scott in this, mindset of Five Nights at Freddy's, because, you know, people complained about the animatronics, about the characters in that game looking like creepy animatronic, things, so... Alright, that's where I need to go to finish this game, but first, I had to pick up one more cupcake, which is at the very beginning of the game. Which I actually never noticed the ledge that you can jump up to until, I looked that up, obviously, but then when I started playing this run, it seemed so obvious. I literally jumped at it, so I was like, oh, it was there the whole time. Backtracking. There we go. Yay! Yeah, check out my triple laser. Aren't I awesome? Anyway, those things are indestructible, right? Yeah, I'm pretty sure they are. I kind of wish I could destroy them, but at the same time, they're not really that hard to dodge, so whatever. Leave them be, I suppose. This music's really cool too. Oh, new dialogue. Wrong. Go back. I think you missed it back there. I don't think I did. So which wall was it in? There's a fake wall up here. Somewhere. Come on. Yeah, even with the high jump, I still suck at platforming. For whatever reason. I'm an embarrassment. I'm a disgrace. Here it is. I'm a seeker finder because I looked it up on the internet. Don't screw this up, don't screw this up. Yay! See, it's not that hard. No, seriously, you missed my hideout. It was back the other way. Yeah, I don't believe that. Oh, and the last one is right there. That's a very tricky place to put it, because you can't even see it. So dumb. But, you know, bravo Scott for tricking everybody like that. Jerk. Oh, you can do that? I never actually tried to hold down the button. I'm a fucking moron. I'm not even joking. Oh, by the way, these are metal men. That's cool too. But yeah, I mean, I never tried that. I'm so stupid. It's much more effective than rapidly tapping the button. This is awesome. Fear my quintuple laser. Anyone else? Quadruple, sorry. I thought I saw 5 bolts. Clearly blind as well as dumb. I like all these health pickups. It's like, yeah, you're near the end, so you might as well be healthy. As healthy as 43 is out of 100. I will grind up your code and use it for the game over screen. No. So anyway, let's- oh shit. I assume so. What's up with your mother brain bullshit? Oh, wow. Max Laser is awesome. Yay, we got Purple Guy. But don't worry, he's not the actual Purple Guy. That's what he told us anyway. So yeah, there we go. Nailed it. I'll probably give it a few more runs to see if I could complete it again without upgrades. Well, yeah, I might as well try at least once. I mean, right, no harm in doing that. And maybe I'll try Foxy Fighters some more and try to get an A rank, so... yeah, that's what we'll try to do. Beyond that, we'll hopefully finish update 2 soon enough, and this whole game. Or not, maybe something else will come out of the woodwork and absolutely destroy us. Anyway, until next time, hasta.
Noobie booby booby. Ha! Poser! Get some skills and call me in the morning. Dumbass. Pathetic. Sad, it's hilarious. I'm losing patience. This is your last chance.